for just a small sum of money, you can get a music box that runs on punched cards. Now, I love punched cards. Unfortunately, it didn't come with punched cards. It came with blank paper tape and a hole punch. And I certainly do not love punching cards. That is effort. And we live in an age of computers and computer-controlled machines. So the first thing I did was cobble together a script, which takes a MIDI file, mangles it a bit, and then spits out a vector image in the right format for my laser cutter. And it worked beautifully. The only problem is that the bed of my laser cutter is just 30 centimetres wide, which means I have to cut them out in strips and then tape them together, which takes effort. Still, it was good enough to get some tunes flowing, and right away I had Mario and Zelda coming out of this thing, and I was winding away furiously, and in my enthusiasm, the handle broke. Obviously, the first thing I did was order another one, but in the meantime, I was left with a broken music box, with no MIDI coming out of it. And as I mentioned, the laser cutter solution did have its flaws. What I needed was a way to cut out the laser cutter and feed my music box MIDI directly. So I came up with this. Thank you. 31 hobby servos, 8 metres of brass wire, and a 150-watt 5-volt power supply. You're looking at the first functioning prototype of my MIDI-mangling music box mechanism. We knew it was going to be noisy when we decided to use these cheapo hobby servos, £1 each. So to try and cut down on vibration, they're all mounted on a sheet of polyurethane foam. The metal comb that produces the sound is still plucked by these wafers, which previously were pulled by the holes in the paper tape. Now they're pushed forwards by these plastic fingers that were cut by laser. When the fingers pull back and the wafers rotate to the vertical, there's a slight dampening effect on the tone. So originally I had the fingers stay forward, and then when a note or message came in, they would pull back, allow the wafers to rotate, and then push forwards again. But the reason I got rid of that is at the time I was having power supply issues, and you know, each servo can draw up to an amp at full torque. So in order to reduce the overall load, I wanted to shorten the movement as much as possible. As an unexpected consequence of that, though, we reduced the latency. So much so that the music box can actually be played with a MIDI keyboard in real time. I must admit, this did take quite a long time to make. The brass linkages here took about half an hour each. So the thought did go through my head, you know, is it worth it? God damn it, of course it's worth it. Even since making this, I've already put at least 100 MIDI files through it. And it's not even finished. Because how can you have a music box without a box?
This here is an ordinary music box. And, only slightly less portable, this is my MIDI music box. At the back we have the standard sockets for MIDI and power, and the rest of the mechanism is pretty much the same. Maybe version 1.1 now, is this motor here is much louder than the rest of them because I've worked so hard to decouple these guys from the rest of the frame. So if we could move this motor to here and then maybe have a belt drive, I think that would make it sound much better. And while we're at it, why not have that belt drive also drive a little ballerina figurine? You know, it'd go with the music box theme. And also we could store some MIDI files onto the chip, have them play automatically when you open the lid. That'd be fun. But in the meantime, I'm just going to play a load of MIDI files.